Hello everyone, welcome to our monthly Blitz event. You know, I've been growing my beard in sympathy for Sandro. You know, we will be look-alike, right Sandro? I mean, next time I'll be in Rome, they wouldn't be able to tell the difference. I will have a Sandro type of beard. That's a serious one. All right, last time, if I remember, there was one young player that actually, well, beat me fair and square. It was an equal game. I tried too much. I wanted to finish with 15. Wasn't that easy. Okay, well, I guess I have to try harder. Maybe you have to try harder. Okay, so Sandro will get us ready and we'll start some play. I will be careful about the 3-2. All right. That's what we have. All right, e4. Okay, you know, today let's play interesting. I don't know. Knight c3, okay. So f4 or bishop c4 or g3, bishop b5. All right. Okay, I'll go d6. Some sort of, okay, capture. But this is, I think, a better, well, maybe not. I was just going to say I think it's a better version for black than the normal one. And then my opponent is playing this f4, which I don't know if I like so much. All right, I'll go g6. And obviously, Aaron is writing to me something right now. One second. Alrighty. Something had to do with Rick and Morty. Let's see, Rick San says, okay, now I will have to read it between the rounds, I guess. Okay. Don't think I like my position so much. No, seriously, like this f4 I didn't like. I thought that I will comfortably get to play what I want to play. It wasn't that easy. Okay, well, we'll see. Explaining. Okay, I was really afraid of my opponent playing f5. Now I think I think I'm more or less okay. Because, okay, I think I can fight against f5 in a better way. Before f5, I thought I was worse. If I will get to play castle and f5 myself, I think I'll be okay. f5 right here by my opponent is also quite interesting. Yeah, but this I don't think should be too much of a concern. Maybe I'll play first rook b8. It just seems healthy to go there. Okay, and now I will castle. Okay, I think I'm really okay. Yeah, g4. Okay, so my opponent wanna go f5, but that's where I have to play f5 myself to block it. Okay. Now what? That's a good question. Now what? I need to find something to do with my knight on e7, and okay, I'm talking too much and playing too slow. Okay, I'll play f4. Oh, sorry, e5, going after f4. This seems somewhat healthy. e5 going after f4 seems somewhat healthy. Yeah, I mean, I have quite a decent center here. This move, I would have to say, is at the very least questionable, but maybe questionable and okay. But questionable. Huh. All right. I need to play tiny faster or speak less or both. All right. I'm going to play something smart. I don't know. I'll take. I don't know if this is something smart, but that's what I apparently played. And this is my idea. Actually, so many pawns in the center. I don't know. This is kind of weird to see so many pawns in the center of the board that way. Really kind of weird. Okay, take. I will take this dude. Ah, yeah. And now I will take this dude, I guess. Yeah, I kind of like this one. I want the f5 square. So knight f5 is my threat. Hopefully I didn't blunder anything. Yeah, this I thought should be good for me. This I thought should be very good for me because if take on f4, I want to take on c3. So that is, you know, that's why this rook b8, rook b1 was kind of, I felt it's kind of useful. Actually, this was a decent game. I think, well, I say it was a decent game. I think I'm winning unless I overlook something here. My opponent has a trick here with rook f1. The idea of rook f1 is that, aha, well, he has this move, which obviously I didn't see, by the way. Obviously I didn't see. My rook is also under attack. Huh. This is true. All right, I have to say 1 minute to the kid before I'm going to lose this game. Okay, because I am going to lose this game if I won't start playing a little bit normal. Okay, like, no, this was annoying. I didn't see anything here, actually. I thought I'm winning. Thank goodness I'm not worse. But, you know, I don't even know already what I do see correctly, what not. But, no, this was kind of ugly. Okay, at least I'm tiny bit ahead on the clock. This I will ask Sando. I have a question for Sando, which I'm typing it to him right now. Okay, my opponent is thinking, which is a blessing, so he can think more. Aha, well, he played a good move. Okay, I have to take, and I'll take. And this, hopefully it's not going to be that easy for him to get to my beautiful pawn. Well, one pawn, but okay, the h4 pawn is also weak. This seems promising. This seems really promising. Okay, well, what to play now? All right, I'll play here. I want to play bishop d4 and kick his king. And then king g4. Okay, check. Okay, that was a decent one. 1 second, I will ask. Oh, okay. Alrighty, well, that was a tough start. That was a tough start, too tough start. Alrighty, well. Okay. White against Nezhmetdinov. I didn't know, I'm embarrassed to say, up until a few years ago, I didn't really know who he was. And then someone was telling me about him. And this dude was one of the greatest geniuses out there, Nezhmetdinov. He was, I think, world champion in, was it backgammon or something like that? And he was amazingly, like, genius mathematician, if I'm not mistaken. And also add to all that, that he was a really strong chess player. I mean, like, not a grandmaster, but okay, that obviously at the level he played, he was a strong grandmaster in today's standard. So this dude was really impressive. Yeah, I have a question. Did the guy resign? No, he's just not playing. Oh, the game before, maybe he did. But this one, I think Sandor will have to start a new game. Okay. All right, white again. Okay. I don't know why I played knight c3. Okay, want to play solid, simple, normal, I guess, at some point. Okay, my opponent is thinking knight c3 is a huge novelty. Okay, this I will take. I don't know how I will play here. Maybe I shouldn't have taken. Okay, I'll go here. All right, castle. Knight f6. Okay, well, all right, give me this. It's not even give me the bishop. He has bishop check there. So what do I play here? I don't really know. Okay, I'm gonna play a bit bizarre. I'm gonna take and play this move. It's a bit bizarre because, okay, I don't want to give him the b2 pawn, although I should have taken on play a4, maybe. Okay, my opponent is playing too fast and actually even too strong, so that's not really that okay. Too fast and too strong. That's not really okay. Okay, what to play here? Okay, I'll go here. Maybe I'm already a bit worse with all this crazy stuff here, but we'll see. Okay, this. Okay, I'll go knight d4. This is complicated position, like really complicated. Not just saying it, pretending it's complicated, but I hope that I will be in time to play somewhat faster there, but I'm not 100% certain. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, actually, I'm too serious about the game because I don't like my position so much. I'm too serious about the game because I don't like my position so much. Okay, let me move my king away. Just get the king out of this diagonal. That has to be somewhat healthy to get out of this diagonal. And then, I don't know. Yeah, because, okay, his king is in the center, but he can castle in one move, and he's... Well, I'm afraid that he can mobilize his pieces. Okay, this is a move I think I should be not so scared after this move. But I also understand that if his knight was not on e4, I think he would be maybe almost lost. I'm not joking. But he can get some annoying stuff here. Like, okay, bishop a6, for example, can be really annoying. Yeah, to my taste, he's playing too good. And bishop a6 is a very, very correct, move to exchange the bishops. Obviously, play that. Yeah. Okay, I will try to play for some complications this way. Nice job pinning. Yeah, but I don't like my position, but... Okay, I will see after this game. It's interesting, my opponent play here. Okay. Yeah, here. Okay, here. Okay, really need to play fast here, I guess. Like super duper fast. Okay, my opponent is taking his time. A lot of his time, one might say. Okay. I have some thoughts here. Okay, this move, okay, I'll go here. Okay, objectively, I'm just lost here. There is no doubts about that. But objectively, I'm lost here. But we will try to keep the game more interesting. Okay, here. This is interesting. Okay, here. Here. The knight is tiny bit trapped, and my opponent flagged, and yeah. Yeah. Oh, all right. Sandro was just telling me not to type exactly when I typed to him. Thank you, John. All right. Oh, wow. I get my kid telling me that I got lucky. Yes, okay. When Aaron is making fun of me, man, that's when you know something is, like, questionable about the play, Sandro. When Aaron is making fun of me here. Mamma mia. Oh, well. Okay, Nezhmadinov, dude, play something. This dude not playing anything. Mr. Nezhmadinov not playing anything. Okay, well, Sandro, I guess playing with Mr. Nezhmodinov is a bit tough. Okay, a4, h5, what's that like? R2, d2. Okay. Man, I'm having insanely difficult games here. Like, the way I'm playing, it's like either I'm going to be incredibly lucky today and survive most of the games, or I'm going to start like getting crushed here, which is not a very cool thought. Okay, no bishop h3. I don't want to give that. No bishop h3. G3, gotta control the center. I'm being laughed at. Oh man. Well, playing fianchetto. It's funny. I played some blitz game on ICC. I played knight f3, and everyone was behind me saying, said, playing like Kramnik. That was like one of the best comment ever. Playing like Kramnik. Okay, now here is the thing. What is happening with this queen there on h5? Is it really that safe over there? I think my job is to try and prove that it is not. That it is not that safe there. How am I going to prove it? I have no clue. Alright, I actually don't. Okay, I'll play this move. Attacking the pawn on c7. Bishop g5 I thought was really strong, but the problem with bishop g5 is knight d4. Yeah, I allow this queen to escape, which... Okay, I mean, I think I'm better here, but... Actually, this would be interesting after the game to go over with Mr. Computer, because I'm kind of have a feeling that bishop g5 or knight g5 might have been stronger, but okay, I was a bit too scared to play. Okay, this I'm gonna play this move. You want to sacrifice? He's more than welcome to sacrifice. I'm not scared. No, I am scared, but. Okay, so he's thinking we are a little bit ahead on the clock. That's not bad. Yeah. Sacrifice. Okay, I can just take on c7, you know? Actually, why not? Ah, should I even bother by this pawn? I mean, my instinct tells me just play e3, Ronen, and I don't know, something. But, you know, it's like, it's a, you know, I'm just going to play e3. Forget about just taking those pawns is just wrong. It's just not healthy. Yeah, okay, I'm going defense. Bishop h2. Yeah, again, I could have taken the pawn e5, but... Not really in the mood for that. Okay, e5. Okay, let me play knight to d5. Ah, knight to d. Okay, let me play king here. Queen e2. Okay, I do feel I could have played somewhat better, but. I also do feel that, okay, I like my position here quite a lot, I think. So, like, okay. Alright, I'll also put my rook in the center. Good for you, good for me. Okay, let's open this beautiful diagonal. Okay, well, we're gonna see who is attacking who very soon. Okay, rook to g1. Ah, I have no time. Okay, I'm gonna take. And take. Ah, and it's 3-0. Okay, thank goodness that at least Sandro is telling me now. Okay, it's okay, Sandro. At least I see this now. That's okay. We will pretend to be really fast. But thank you for telling me, oh man. One game, like two blitz games ago that I lost. Okay, I found out that no increment with 5 seconds or 3 seconds. This time, we will pretend to be super duper fast. All right. But also the position is kind of pleasant here. Basically, game over. Okay. Yeah, this sacrifice on g4 is really nothing. Like, I mean, like, it's really, really nothing. Especially when there are all the pieces there, but usually just the knight on f3 is enough to kind of show that there is about nothing there. Oh, man. Okay, oh, dude, there is someone, the Jedi here. He's challenging me to a blitz game. My time is 0-2 versus 3-2 his. Is he joking? This is not the time control you are watching. You're welcome, A4, H5. Like, I think the Jedi was trying to pull some Jedi trick on me. Okay. Everyone is playing this knight c3. Okay, I'm going to go back to my boring Scandinavian. Yeah, I don't want to play this thing. Ugh. No power for this close Sicilian. I analyzed it seriously about 25 years ago. Last time I super duper seriously analyzed this. Okay. Well. Okay, this I go here. Okay, here. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't have allowed this thing. Maybe. Okay, you know, I'm gonna take. Yeah, and I'm gonna stick this one here. We will see. Okay, my position is really bad. I just played super stupid, actually. Super duper stupid. Seriously. Ugh. No, just played really bad. Yeah, I didn't think this is such a bad position for me, but actually it is. Actually, this is a bad position. Yeah, this I'm really not happy. No, this is really bad position. And believe it or not, I'm not even faking it. Okay. Okay, my opponent I don't think played very well. Okay, but now if I get this a4, I think I'm alive. I mean, I really think I got a lot of counterplay. Honestly, if you ask me, way more than I thought I should get. Okay, knight a4. Knight going to c3. No, my opponent played wrong. I mean, I really hated my position, as I very honestly showed. Okay, but this I'm quite happy. Okay, I think my B pawn is more dangerous. Right, I can play queen a3 here. No, I think this is really bad for him. Yeah, I mean, look at the position that I had. Actually, it would be interesting for my opponent, if he wants and have energy, to go after this game, how you know, with this B3 and allowing me express idea, I just wanted to get some passpawn open somehow, the position there somehow. And this thing just immediately allowed it. Yeah, because here I really think just bad position for him. Okay, this is actually, I guess, a good move. I guess so. Okay, but I'll just bring my rook. Actually, maybe queen c1 is my next move if I can play that. The thing is that his pawn is completely not dangerous. Yeah. This is correct play by him. This is correct by him. Just when I said his pawn is not dangerous. How should I play now? This is not clear. Should have played better, I think, a move ago, but I'm not certain. This. Okay, let's see. Here. This is not clear. Okay. I don't know what to play. Okay, I'll play King F8. Maybe I'll bring my king to fight with his passpawn, as bizarre as it may seem. Maybe this is what I want to play. Yeah, I played really bad, you know. I'm quite certain about that. Played really bad. No, this King F8 was beyond ridiculous move. It was very, very bad move. Yeah. Yeah, it was very, very bad move. Actually, I really don't like my position, like, really. No, it was such a stupid move, I don't even understand it. Okay. Maybe I'm lost here. No, just one stupid move in this really complicated position. No, that was worse play. I thought that I have all the time in the world, and I felt that he can maybe open the game and attack me, but somehow I thought that I have absolutely all the time in the world, and now I think I'm kind of getting checkmated. I just really think so, you know? Yeah, I think I'm just lost here. Which is super stupid, because I really think I was... when my knight was on c3, okay, I got too comfortable. I really, really got too comfortable there for some bizarre reason. Yeah, I'm just lost. Incredible. It's incredible how stupidly I lost this game. No, just horrible. No, I felt I'm playing bad, but this is just disgusting. Okay, now I'm allowed to get angry and to say that it's just humiliating how I play this one. Oh, well. Okay, this was... Okay, he should go and see how I got a winning position, and I should go and do even a harder work, see how I completely butchered this one. That was not really pretty. Okay, so now I'm between kind of mad and zero mood for this blitz thingy. Oh well. Story of life. No. King F8, like I have 1,000 moves there. I could have just exchanged queens and then F5. I mean, I know I'm kind of winning there, or much, much better. That's my feeling. Just exchange queens. Okay, well, 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 well. All right, if I'm too quiet, it's because I kind of want to throw up from the way I played, so I'm allowed to do that. Well, hopefully not throwing up during the game, but maybe. Okay. Okay, back to our beautiful, beautiful, lovely beautiful, lovely game. Okay, well, black is at least okay here. I mean, maybe a bit more than okay in this position. I think tiny, tiny bit better, I would say. Yeah, tiny better because, okay, I think I'm going to play c5 just to fix the c4 pawn. I think that's quite healthy. No, this is a bit better. This is just a bit better for black. Maybe after this move, okay. This is critical for me to play because I don't want him to get an easy e4. And then we shall see. Yeah, c5 was interesting, but maybe I should have stuck bishop e4 before. Okay, I'll play interesting, you know? I'll go after the c4 pawn. If he wants to take the exchange, he's welcome to take the exchange. If he wants to take the exchange, he's welcome to take it. Okay, but if I take, I think this is the end of this game. Yeah, you know, the c5 and playing against c4 and c3 was quite serious in this position. But okay, just take. Excuse me, look at White's bishop on a3. That's not much for him there. Yeah, okay, I don't even know if I want to take the exchange, to be honest. Okay, I will. But I thought also just normal play. Okay, and going after the a4 pawn looks healthy. Okay, and just not to do anything crazy in this position is the most logical thing in this position. Not more, not less. Okay, this pawn I can have. Okay, start pushing our pawns. We have many pawns, we can start pushing them. All right. You know, just don't want to get my queen trapped there. You know, the way I'm playing, that's the next thing to happen is somehow getting my queen trapped over there. All right, let me go here. Get our queen here, and then start, and then continue pushing the pawns. Okay, the queen has 1,000 squares, we have time. Okay, that was not such a horrible game. Win or lose, stay positive, it's attractive. It's, okay. Well. Okay. No, it was just showing the c3 and c4 squares in this type of play. Okay, quite serious squares over there. Once black captures on c3 and white has those weak pawns, it can maybe be not so pleasant there. Maybe not so pleasant. All right. Some more play. Mate or die? My goodness, that's a serious name. Mate or die? All right, let's play some Vienna stuff. I don't know. If I play here, is he going to take on e4? Okay. If he didn't take, I'll play d3. Okay, this I want to play with f4. Sometimes the idea of, actually the most accurate move order is to first play bishop c4, the bishop opening. And then d3 and f4 is what's in the cards in this line. Okay, here. Yeah, I don't think I'm that, you know, eager to castle, I mean, okay, I cannot castle kingside, but even so, the king is perfectly okay at the center. But, okay, I can castle this way. Okay, let's move the king away. I mean, I think white should be just happy. I mean, exchanging the f for the e pawn is always very decent for white. Okay, I'll play rook to f1. Maybe I will do something on the f file at some point. Okay, I'll play h3. Okay, I just want to play on the f. Okay, if he goes here, okay, I'll pull back. Take. Okay, this is all right for him. Yeah, I tiny bit played. Okay, I'll go back. I tiny bit played too safe, if I can use that way of describing it. I played, I think, too safe. Okay, he wants to play d5 and my queen is there. I kind of want to move my queen away. Okay, just waiting for the right moment. Okay, I'm gonna play this now. I just wanna somehow get this knight on f5 and play on the f-file that I've been wanting to do, like, kinda forever, pretty much. Okay, so can he play d5? Does he want to play d5? I don't know. Okay, if he's playing there, I think I should be somewhat happy here. maybe not too much, but okay, you know, I will also pull my knight. I don't know. I want to meet d5 with e5. I think that's kind of decent idea. Okay, I do want to exchange. I like my structure. Remember I said many moves ago that I think slash hope that I'm going to get some pressure on the f-file. In this structure, once you play the 4, that's exactly where you want to go. That's exactly, I mean, just, okay, some pressure on the f-file. The bishop on b4 also might be a little bit questionable. Okay. So does he want to play d5 and attack my knight will be undefended? Maybe. Okay, I'll play this move. If d5, I think my e5 is quite strong. Okay, this move. Okay, I'll go here. Actually, this was... I don't like this move so much. Yeah, my knight cannot really stay there. Okay. I let him a bit off the hook with knight d4. Okay, now he kind of has to move the knight because... Yeah, okay, that's good play. He's playing not bad. I'm still better here, but much less than before. Okay, now I need to play classical g4, h4 type of play. This should be my idea. And attack the f6. Again, everything is on the f-file. You know, I'm going to say f-file. Everything is on the f-file in this position, as far as I'm concerned. Okay, there are actually some classical games. Oh man, like some either Rubinstein or Capablanca. Okay, I need actually my king on g3. I want to get my king on g3. But okay, this we're going to play very slow here. Very slow. I mean, my only shot is really either d4 and some break in the center or h4, g5 at some point. One of those moves. Okay, I'll bring the king. My opponent doesn't have time, so I think I might be really lazy and just try to win on the clock. Okay, now maybe the pawn over there is also a bit weakness. The a6 pawn. Okay, my knight will go here. Now I like it a bit more. Okay, here. I like that I have a weakness on a6 also, or my opponent has. Okay, I don't know, c3. Yeah, this move, this is actually a good move. Okay, I'll go here. Okay, and our h4, right? I mean, I have to, yeah, and g5. You know, it's a very slow play. I mean, I said it 1,000 moves ago, but this is our way of playing. Okay, rook f1, knight here. I mean, I have no other way to play, right? And I think I'm winning the pawn here. If I play this move, and my smart idea that just to be certain is not blundering is to take on g7. If rook takes f2, I take. He takes with his rook. And then king e1, and okay, he resigned. And then king e1, and my pawn is moving. You know, I think this was quite decent when many moves before, it was clear what's my plan, and I don't think I deviated even the slightest from that, right? Like playing g4, g5, attacking f6. That's the plan. There's no other plan. All right. Okay. Number three against Mr. Nezhmedinov. Ah, a move. A move is incredible. Okay, c4. All right, g3. Okay. I don't know how I even got to that position. Not a great version. No, okay, I don't know why I played g3 and not d4 earlier on. But okay, that's what we have here, that's what we have. Okay, I'll castle. Okay, can I take on e5? I don't know if I can. I'm taking there. First I'm taking there, then we will see. Yeah, but this I thought... Okay, rook take. And I'm gonna take this one. I don't think he has anything really for that. Okay, this move, I'll go all the way to f1. Yeah, I mean, he doesn't have a dark color bishop, so how weak is really e3 and those squares? Not really. I mean, okay, now just develop. I don't need to do anything crazy, stupid. Maybe I will throw some h3. Objectively, the game is over. Okay, let me go after his knight. I just want to take it. I just develop, you know? Nothing else one should care about. Because white's a pawn up. Yeah, I could take the pawn on b7 and go back. But you might believe me or not, I didn't even see that. It's not even... Okay, I just want to take this one. Okay, and take it again. And queen d2. Okay, and rook f1, that's over. Yeah, it was maybe already a bit over after rook takes f5. Okay, I think I can just take on f6, but you know, when you see the queen on d7, the rook on e8, the king on g8, I don't know, it just seems that getting a knight to f6 is gonna be something, right? Pretty much, okay, no, not many more pieces are left to be under attack. So that's pretty much it. Okay, queen for a rook, I can handle. Well, my opponent maybe doesn't believe me, but I really can handle this. That's a decent moment to give up. Tired dead. Oh man, that's a interesting one. Okay, symmetrical English we go. Symmetrical English we go. Okay, I'll play with e6. I want to see if I can get knight g7. Well, okay, I cannot. Actually, this is a game I already kind of lost today. Very similar style, like some type of closed Sicilian. So, is it going to be number two? Hope not. I sure hope not. Okay, very clear. Black wants some a6, b5, white wants some f4, g4, like very much how the game I lost went, like that's very, very basic. Yeah, exchanging the bishop on g7, you know, I don't know how incredibly powerful this idea is. I mean, I know they play this way. I can go rook e8, bishop h8 if I'm really, really bothered by this idea. Okay, you know what? Let me annoy my opponent. I'll play this move. Actually, now it's interesting. How is he going to defend the d3 square? Oh my gosh. I mean, I've seen some compositions, some puzzles like that. That's just funny. That's a little bit funny, I think. Huh. Okay, he has one way to play. I will let him think and then I will suggest it. He has one way to play here. I don't think this is the one. I thought knight f4, e5, and a3. Okay, now I think I just took most important central pawn. Okay, I shall, you know, I think I'm gonna take another one. Why not? I will take another one. Yeah, he had to play knight f4. He couldn't have given me that pawn. Okay. Tired dad is really tired. Tired dad is really tired. That's quite for certain. All right. What else do we have? All right. Then 9, 10, 7, 12. Could it be Dan that was born on 12th of July, 1991? Is that possible, Dan? All right, I'll go with this love with Mr. Dan. Okay, I'll play here. I want my bishop out in e6. I like this pawn chain, b7, c6, d5, against the bishop on g2. I think, there are many systems, but I find this to be a very simple and very simple system. Okay, rook e8. Black has great development. The most important thing is the bishop on g4, right? If the bishop on c8, okay, I will take, and I will play e5. This is typical play. White is also okay. Now, actually, there are a few ways to play, but I'll just take and go here. I want to exchange the dark color bishops, right? Because I'm really fantasizing on this square on d4 for my knight. That is my goal. Yeah, I think that maybe bishop c3 was best play for my opponent, and after bishop c3, I would have played bishop b4. And you see some games that they just make a draw that way. Just the game is just drawn this way. Okay, I'll play this g6. Now, is f4 worth anything? I don't really think so. Yeah, I like black. Look at the bishop on g2 versus my knight. Yeah, I should have played knight c5. Amazing. Just knight c5 and move earlier. Okay, I'll see if I can make it from this way. D4 is the destination for this knight. D4 is absolutely the destination of this knight. Okay, black is just a bit better, I think. But probably if white had played bishop c3, it would okay. Okay. What to play here? No, okay, I cannot think that much. That's crazy. I just fell asleep. Okay, I'll just play fast. Okay, I play. Yeah, I missed one move, and now from being better, it's just equal. Soon I'll be worse. Yeah. No, I'll be worse. That was really, 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 really horrible play. Just ugly play. Okay, still about equal, I guess, but how did this happen? Like, that his pawn is on c5? That should not have happened. Okay, take. Okay. I don't know if I want to exchange the queens, but I did. Okay, I think objectively it's about equal. Okay, about a minute for each player. Maybe I'm tiny bit worse here. Tiny bit. Okay, I don't want bishop c8. Yeah. Okay, technically it's just equal, but my opponent can make a draw. All right, we will let him make a draw. I'm gonna play here. I don't know, somehow I'm... Okay, now he gave me this f4 square. Okay, we will see. You know, you make a draw when you make a draw. I'm going to be annoying, more than usual, right? You know that I'm annoying. And, okay. Try to be... Yeah, the thing is that... Okay, wow. Okay, should I... Okay, I'll play this move. Yeah, I thought I can play maybe first. Okay, this. Okay, I'll go here. I just want to win this pawn, you know? That's all I want to do. Okay, here. Okay, I think actually, not as to usual of my complaints, I think here I'm playing quite good. Here. So my opponent knight is paralyzed so far, at least. I have one weakness I have to keep an eye on, that's the b7 pawn. I'll play first this move. The pawn on h6 is going nowhere. Okay, he went here. Can I take this one? Okay, I hope I... Okay, now b5 is my idea. But maybe I allowed him his knight to f5. Maybe he will have some chances here in the pawn endgame. I don't know. Man, this chess is a tough game, too tough. Okay, that's funny. The pawn endgame is a draw, but I want this one. Okay, now what does he want to do? Okay, I want here. Yeah, and I'm not going to allow you to play knight f8. And now you're going to resign. You know, it's like this g4 started some weaknesses, and okay, all the pawns have disappeared. All the pawns have just disappeared in this position for. Okay, here, here, here. I'm just going to run with my pawns. And hopefully the knight is a bit trapped. Okay, no knight g6 even. Bye-bye knight. Okay. I can play many moves. Okay, he can resign here, right? All right. Knight f3. My opponent lagging. Or what? I think, Sandro, I think he's lagging a bit, this dude. All right, some new game. Okay, today actually many games, like people, I don't know, were they so surprised they're playing or weird? They're just, okay. One to a bazillion I'll get to play. So at the swimming pool. Okay, mister, you are him. What's happening? What's shaking? What's shaking over there? Okay. He's just nice man, giving me 30 seconds ahead on the clock. All right, I'll take it, you know. In our situation, we have to take anything we can. All right. Petrosian system, right? Don't want bishop b4. Okay, I think if I can get d5, I should take it. The idea is that I cannot play d5 before because of the move bishop b4. But now, if I can play d5 and block the bishop on b7, that's not so bad. I mean, the main move for black. Black has two main moves instead of bishop e7, playing knight e4 and playing d5. Both of them are kind of fighting against white's d5. Yeah, this is, I think, white's better. Because white is normally not supposed to be able to get this thingy. Yeah, okay, this is okay, the way he's playing. He wants to put his knight on c5. But okay, I mean, I'll play slow. I think I have the center and space. Maybe I played something tiny bit, not that great here, but okay, rook e1. Okay, so some sort of King's Indian, but look at the bishop on b7. That bishop on b7 is not that amazing. And he doesn't have a4. Okay, so I'm going to kick him with b4. I think I should be better here, but I would prefer my bishop on e2. I wouldn't lie about that. Okay, let me see if the bishop there is good. Let's stick the bishop over there. Okay. Okay, I'll play normal King's Indian. Okay, I'll take knight here. I think by all normal standards, this should be a bit in black, in white's favor. Okay, bishop e3. Okay, this I will take. I like the e4 square. The e4 square is not bad. So let's stick our knight over there. Okay, and c5. I mean, if I'm not gonna go for c5, then what am I selling in this position? Now, knight g5. This Sandor would tell me, Ronen, how come you're not going for the e6 square if I won't play knight g5? So I have to play knight g5. But the e6 square is big. I mean, okay, even if my opponent had a pawn on h6, I thought I would be a little bit better, but this is just pretty here. Dude, but this is check, right? This is check. You know, this was just a decent game with space. I mean, nothing too bad. Nothing. I mean, okay, playing a bit with more space. You're welcome. In the opening, my opponent did the wrong thing that he little bit wrong. Okay, after a3, you're not supposed to allow white to play d5. All right. E4. Okay, we'll go this way. Okay. What shall I play? Okay, I wanted to play maybe the Austrian with F4, but okay, we'll play more simple. Too complicated to go for some F4. Man, I'm tired, actually. I have to say I'm tired. It's a little after 12. Don't know why I'm so tired. I shouldn't be, but I am. Okay. Normal stuff, right? Everything here is normal, normal, normal. This is actually not so normal. You're welcome. My opponent is very nice once again, thanking me for the game, and once again he is welcome. Okay, bishop d3. All right. Yeah, what to play here? I don't really know. Okay, I'm going to go for like a chicken to some endgame. Probably there were better ways to play, but I really... Oh, man, my opponent is telling me endgame. I see no endgame. All right, he's correct. But okay, so now at least it's going to be a bit more complicated. He is correct. All right. This is interesting. What's the time situation? Very equalish. Knight on c1 is quite pretty. right? Protecting a lot of squares. In some situations when my opponent, I hope he's not going to get too aggressive and think about sacrificing, but the knight can also cover the b file with knight b3. Okay, you know, playing this move g5 makes me nervous about my beautiful queen over there, so I want my queen out. Don't even think about trapping my queen, mister. Can I go here? Nah, I could probably go e5, but I don't know. I'm just trying to play as normal, solid, chicken style as possible. That's my theme. Okay, it's not a bad one. Okay. Where should I go? Okay, I'll go knight h3. Okay, knight f4. I mean, okay, I'm just playing very normally. Remember what I said before, that whenever knight a3 or some nasty, evil ideas like this are on the table, I always have knight b3, which I think is healthy. You know, actually, let me just play knight b3 now. My opponent will play queen c5, okay, you know, queen g5. I'll take and we'll go just to an endgame. He has a very bad h pawn. And if he's going to take, okay, well, but now I can get to play this move, which I really like. I mean, I think I'm just much, much, much faster over there. Okay, I don't even know if it's right or wrong. I'm just trying to open the position. It has to be right. Well, checkmate is definitely right. Yeah, it was, I mean, it was actually very decent. I think my opponent should have accepted the queen exchange. Oh, the queen offer, yeah. I thought so. All right. Okay, one game, oh man. That one game was not very cool, the one that I lost. No, not because this King of Fate was kind of ridiculous. All right, let's see. So, Sandro is deciding who's going to play next. Virtuoso. Alrighty. Some scary picture there. Okay, I'll stick to knight f3. Hi, Ronen. Hi, Virtuos. Do we know each other? Well, maybe he's just being polite. Okay. Queen's gambit decline. Okay. Well, there's something what can I say about this thing other than bazillion games have been played in every known world championship to mankind forever and ever and ever. This move, I'm not certain I know, actually. I don't know what to play here. Okay, I want to delay moving the bishop on f1, right? Because I want to be able to capture on c4 in one move. All right. I don't want to give you my bishop. Okay, so what should he play? You know, I'm not going to exchange. Why am I not going to exchange? Because I think that I have more space. And if I really have more space, I don't think I'm that eager to go and exchange. Just my logic. Yeah, I don't know if playing knight d2 is going to be way too much. Oh, you know, I'm going to be funny. Or maybe not funny, maybe just stupid. But maybe here I think I could have just exchanged. Yeah, I thought that's what you want to go and that I'm pushing it a bit too much. I thought so. Okay, you know, let's play interesting. I'll play f3. Okay, alright. Man, this dude has like 1,000 knights there. An army of knights. That's like 1,000 knights. Alrighty. But also some weak squares in the position. Also some weak squares like e5, c5, b6, e6 pawn. But okay, all in all, it's, let's say, very interesting game. If you ask me five moves ago, if I would imagine that this is the position we're going to have, I would tell you no. Not, I mean, couldn't even see anything closer to that. But, well, that's why it's kind of funny. Okay, at some point I think, whoops, I'm not going to allow him this one. I was going to say at some point I want to go c5 and b4, but yeah, maybe I should have played it. Yeah, my opponent is playing good. He's definitely playing good. Yeah, I mean, I think he get really decent amount of counterplay here. I mean, okay, he got it because I was very kind to allow all this to him. That's me. Super duper kind GM, allowing his opponent to attack him for free. Joking, no joking, I don't like my position so much. Okay, I'll play this. Yeah, I don't like my pawn, you know, we are joking, we are here, we are there, but I don't like my position so much. Okay, I'll take like this. But okay, maybe if I can pull my idea in the next move, we will feel a bit more pleasant here. Okay, and this move? No, it's... I never liked close positions. Never, ever, ever, never. But, okay, I think nobody likes... Or almost nobody likes close positions. Or at least, I don't know. All right. This story. Okay, I'll play. Do I want to play b6 or not? Okay, I'll play b6. Because b6 really kills his bishop kind of like forever, I guess. But maybe I shouldn't. Maybe I shouldn't. Okay, I'll go here. There is one line here that I'm a little bit scared of. I hope my opponent is not going to play that. Yeah, okay, this I'm not so scared, I think. I was very worried about him sacrificing on f4 immediately. Well, somewhat worried. Probably still okay for me. But now, how do I get to b7? Oh my gosh, okay. Let's see, is this a smart maneuver or a stupid one? I don't know. Either way, that's the way I'm taking. Okay, so my big idea here is that he's playing without a bishop. His bishop on b8 is dead. Okay, this... Okay, I'm willing to exchange. Now I just have to be really careful about him playing g5, right? I guess so. Okay, knight d2. Okay, let me get bishop back. Okay, here. Everyone is maneuvering like some incredible. Okay, this. Okay, bishop d2. Oh my gosh, no time! Ah! No time! Okay, rook a1. We have increment at least. But again, my big thing saying is playing without a bishop, right? That was the big idea of b6. Really saying, claiming, thinking is playing without a bishop. And all those nice maneuvers I did, one idea, attack b7. Okay, but I can go here. I don't need to open anything. I don't need to change anything. Nothing. I mean, I think that I'm just the one in control in this position. So unless somehow I blunder something, oh man, this is nasty. Okay, move, move, move. So I was, oh man, chess, tricky, annoying game. Okay, I want to go back. Ugh. Why is he pushing his pawn so fast? Stop pushing your pawn, mister. Okay. But now I think we kind of survive here. Okay, wow. That's like checkers, dude. Oh, wow. We are playing checkers. He's giving and I'm taking. He's giving and I'm capturing. Wow, that was, I think, positionally a good game, but became tiny bit tricky. Yeah, there's a very, very famous game of, I don't remember, someone strong. I think Capablanca, that like really squeezed his opponent, kind of similar. There it was actually on both sides of the board. So, but really, this, it came from similar stuff, and he put a pawn on b6, and then actually also on the king side, and then you just find a way to break through. All right. Okay, Nimzo Indian. We didn't even have one Nimzo yet. Ah, this line. Okay, I'll go here. Oh man, it's like playing like Carlsen and Anand. They all play this first knight f3 tricky move. My gosh, and it's freezing. Okay, I don't know what to play here. Okay, I'll go this way. Man, I think I almost blundered a piece. No, I don't want to blunder a piece. I want to take. I don't want to blunder. Okay, this. Yeah. What to play here? I don't know. All right. Okay, take castle. Yeah, now I have to play one move. I have to play e5. I cannot allow him e5. Now the structure, if there are some people that remember, well, the structure is Spassky-Fischer from their match, game 5. This is kind of Spassky-Fischer from their match. Actually, there's one other move I need to put in this position. Yeah, maybe c5 I needed to play. Because c5 is not a bad idea by my opponent. Actually, why I didn't play h6? Ugh. Alright, I'll play it now, so no bizarre questions. Yeah, this is how I should go. Okay, g5 or not g5? Alright, let's make it interesting. Here, sticking the knight on f4. No, you know, I'll play c5. I don't know what I should play. Okay, let me stick this one here. Yeah, I knew he's gonna take. Okay, I go. Okay, I play here. Not certain I needed to play this move, but this move. If this move, can't I take it? Alright. I am going to take. No, I think it's a pawn. Okay, now it's winning for certain. I thought he had to play king g2, but no, I don't think he can. e4 is weak, d4. Okay, now his king is also weak. I think I'm winning another pawn because queen e3 is a threat. So probably he has to play like queen e2, and then I'm just... Okay, I said queen e3 is a threat. I mean that. I'll play here. Now it's kind of checkmate very soon. Very, very soon. Yeah, that was... Again, by the way, playing against those weak pawns, playing against those things, not really that bad. Not really that bad. You know, when you have some targets, easy to play against. All right, e4. Big move. Sandro, I'm going to ask Sandro, how many more games do we have? I don't know, 2, 3, I don't know, because some games were over, really, you know, just the opponent didn't play, so Sandro is the boss of all bosses, especially from the Italian mafia. Sandro is the John Gotti of chess. All right, let's see what Sandro's telling me. This one and one more. Okay, that's called 2 games. Okay. All right. H3 is useful against bishop g4, for example, in such position. Oh man, so after all this noise, what are we getting here? Some Velu Pest type of play. I really wanna... Okay, I'll take here and go bishop g5 and try to fight for the d5 square, but maybe playing d5 was more accurate. Maybe playing d5 was more to the point. Okay. Now I'm going to take again. I really want... I just want the d5 square. Yeah, this what I want. What it's worth? Okay, we'll see. Okay, take, take. Wow. This is interesting. Okay, you saw that I was playing it really fast. Because, okay, I just feel that... Okay, I feel this is going to be Mamma Mia dangerous for him. I mean... It's a pawn, but I get to play here. I think this is dangerous for him. But maybe I'm wrong. Oh man. Okay, either I'm going to be super super smart here, or I'm going to be super stupid. And don't tell me what you think it's going to be, because I don't want to hear that. Okay, so if I play rook takes e5, he can play f6, right? And then it looks dangerous, yippee yippee, but I don't know how to continue. But what if I play queen h8, king e7, and then queen takes g7? Isn't that really smart? Alright, I don't see a defense for him, so I hope it is. And if I miss something... Oh, man, that's not gonna be pretty if I missed something. So I better not miss anything here. So I better not miss anything here. Yeah, I think this is... Yeah, that's why I played kind of knight d5. You know, without even much calculating, I just kind of thought that, all right, you know, it like just should be so much there. And it's a pawn that I most likely easily can get back. So it didn't seem like the world most complicated, almost dangerous sacrifice. Alrighty, one more after this baby. I think it's just winning a straight. Yeah, if this move I wanted to play check, and then this check, I have no problem exchanging everything, right? When I'm a pawn up, I'll be quite happy doing that. Right, rook d7, queen e6, just exchange. Pawn endgame, pawn up is healthy. And king c7, I'll take the pawn on f7. So this is it for this one. This is it for this one. Okay, this I take. Yeah, I mean, this I don't like. I mean, possible to resign in this moment. Okay, also possible not to resign. All right, so I'll take. I don't know. I don't think he has half a perpetual here. Alrighty. Okay, I'm just going with one pawn to promote. If he has no checks, I don't care about anything there. Just go with one pawn, you know, as long as there are no perpetuals in queen endgame, what should really be important is the quality of the pawns, not the amount of the pawns. But okay, let's be a bit fancy and capture here. And I've seen some games like this that black play queen take with a check, and oh my gosh, some similar things, the nastiest thing ever. Like, just be careful, queen take, it's not a check. Okay, this is gonna be all right. All right, my opponent is a big fighter, but you know, dude, ugh. I was never a big fan of continuing those positions. Okay. Well, last game. Yeah, this was a cool idea. I mean, the queen take g7, but it made somewhat sense. Okay, Nimzo, Queen's Indian were kind to me today, so we'll continue with that. Alrighty. Okay, bishop a6. Yeah, actually it was some really, really cool game. I mean, games were, I think because I played consistently same openings, so I think it was, I hope, it was quite productive. Okay, man, he wants to attack me. The game didn't even start. Ugh, help. All right. Okay, thank goodness, castle. I don't know. Don't this knight e5, you know, scaring me. But what should I play here? I know my position is okay. What to play? Ah. Man, okay, I'll go c5. I think it's normal, everything is developed. I think that's quite normal play. Yeah, take is okay. Okay, here, how would I play? Okay, I'll take here. Ah, I should have taken on d4 first, I think. All right, maybe no big difference. And then I shall take here, here, and here. I like my position. I hope so, at least. And this move, how to take actually here? This is interesting. Okay, I'll take like this. Yeah, pawn take also a bit better for white, I think, but okay, but this is, I don't know, just very, should be at least very nice for white. Actually, this is going to be a pawn up. This I'm taking, don't even ask me. This I'm taking. Now my opponent needs to be careful not to lose a piece against knight f5. And rook d1, I take on c3 and knight e2 is winning. Like, those knights that are... knights are killer pieces. Right? Alright, this one's over. Alright, actually... we're a lot of interesting game in Nimzo slash Queens Indian type. I thought, you know, I was more consistent with type of opening I played, and I played a lot of Sicilians. All right, but that's it for today. That's it for today. Wasn't bad. Okay, I need to tiny bit improve, but maybe hopefully we'll get to do that next month. All right, well, bye-bye.